Hi everyone, good evening. So welcome to this new video wherein we will be discussing the editorial of The Hindu dated 26th March 2019, which is today. So guys, in the previous video of the current affairs series, we did see that how do we go ahead with reading the newspaper if we are doing it for the first time, right? If you are a beginner, you have never read the newspaper from the examination perspective, how do you go ahead with that? So that is something which we tried seeing in the previous video. Apart from that, I hope that was helpful. Many of you messaged also, but still, apart from that, there are also other videos which are available on this particular channel. The links of all the playlists have been given in the description box of this particular video. So if you want, you can check them. It will save your time in, you know, going through the channel and the playlists. Everything is available at one place. The other thing is, if you want to get connected to me via any other social media platform, all the links are available in the channel description. So I am available on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Telegram channel I have, wherein I keep informing about any video that I upload. So I give the link, share the link there also. And if you need to check some of my NCERT courses which are there on Unacademy, you can check them out. Someone asked me, I guess a few days ago or maybe yesterday, I don't remember exactly, that am I covering the same content which I have done on Unacademy? So I would like to make it public. I answered that person. It was a genuine doubt, but I am making it very clear here also that I am not at all covering something which I have done on Unacademy. That is completely different. I don't want to waste my time just because I need to have more viewer traffic or subscriber traffic. That's not the reason. So I am not doing what I have done there. Every single thing which I am doing here is very new. And even if I teach, you know, the same subjects which I have taught there, I will not be doing it as the summary of the books. I'll be doing it in a different way. So don't worry, the contents are not at all same on both the platforms. You have completely different content. Uske alawa, guys, if you are liking these videos, if you think that these videos are helping you in any way in your preparation, in understanding that how to read, and not exactly giving you the summary or the analysis which is done everywhere, you know, in this world and on the digital world also, you're getting so many summaries and analysis. I'm sorry, I'm not doing that for you. I am only teaching you how do you go ahead, how you be independent of, you know, how will you gain confidence that, okay, even if I am new to this particular thing, I can read the newspaper on my own. So this is my approach and this is my effort. Let's see how it goes. उसके अलावा आपको जो दिख रहा होगा स्क्रीन पे, आप बोलेंगे आप तो साथ में नोट्स बनाते हो, सब कुछ, एवरीथिंग इज रिटन हियर. व्हाट हैपेंड वाज, आई हैड ऑलरेडी, यू नो, आई वाज रिकॉर्डिंग सिंस पास्ट हाफ एन आवर एंड मैंने ऑलमोस्ट ये पूरा आर्टिकल कवर कर दिया था. आई हैड रीच्ड समवेयर हियर, आई डोंट नो व्हाट टेक्निकल, और ये वाला ना पढ़ना बाकी था. सो यू कैन सी, ये आधा में ऐसे लिखा हुआ है विच यू कैन सी ऑन द स्क्रीन. And I was about just to finish it, some technical error happened, I don't know what happened, and the video was closed. So again, I am recording, this is the second attempt I am doing. Already aadhe ghante 40 minute ki puri energy mehnat khatam ho gayi usme. So therefore you find everything written here, and mujhse nahi ho paya ki main isko delete kar dun. So I'll be explaining you know, the written part and the one given in the summary, the editorial, side by side. But when I was doing that video, the previous one, I had assumed that you guys are doing it for the first time. Anybody who is seeing this video, I am assuming that you are reading an editorial from examination perspective for the first time. So you are a beginner, and at the max, what you know is the syllabus. Wo bhi vague idea aapko syllabus ka. These are my assumptions, and I'll be seeing you, showing you how it goes. ठीक है? So let's quickly start this. अब और time नहीं waste कर सकते. मैंने already बहुत बोल लिया है आज, तो और वो पूरा waste हो गया. So the title says, अब जो जो मैं दिखा रही हूँ ना, सिर्फ उस पर focus करना. I will be highlighting and whatever I am showing, just focus on that because a bit things are written here. Balancing work. Now when suppose we are starting reading this editorial which is picked up from The Hindu, आज का है, open ed का है, open editorial page का, 26th March 2019, ठीक है. Balancing work. Now this article roughly gives us an idea, but it is not making us clear that what exactly can be the entire topic about. The second part, the subheading जो है उसका, it says more women can be a part of the workforce only if men share the burden of unpaid care work. So here the point is that even if we suppose we do not know the syllabus, first of all, since they are discussing about women and men, and they are talking something about work and workforce, So it is related to society because men and women are involved, and therefore we say that it is related to the social issues. ये common sense से, इसलिए नहीं कि UPSC का syllabus है, common sense है. Heading पढ़ के कैसे पता करोगे that for which paper this is applied for? ठीक है, फिर proper content पढ़ के तो समझ आ ही जाएगा. Sometimes there are overlapping papers also, but just you know, बिल्कुल beginner कोई कैसे कर सकता है, वो सिखाने की कोशिश कर रही हूँ. चलो, दिस इज वन इन्फरेंस दैट वी ड्रू फ्रॉम द हेडिंग एज वेल एज द सब हेडिंग. अगेन, सिंस इट इज स्पेसिफिकली टॉकिंग अबाउट वुमेन, सो वी ऑल्सो अंडरस्टैंड दैट इट इज सम हाउ डीलिंग विद वुमेन इश्यूज. नाउ ये आप दो मिनट के लिए जेंडर भूल जाओ, क्योंकि उस टाइम भी मैंने बाद में लिखा था. सो वी आर डीलिंग विद वुमेन इश्यूज. नाउ सिंस वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट वुमेन एंड मेन, एंड वी आर टेलिंग दैट only if men share the burden of unpaid care work. Iska matlab women unpaid, unko job karna pad raha hai, they are not getting paid, which means kind of inequality ka problem hai yahan pe, you know, that is what somehow we are going to discuss. So equality or inequality you can write. Ab uske aage wo social kyun laga tha, that I'll be showing you when we reach to that point of the article. I hope you know this entire thing, why did I write it earlier, I hope that is clear. How do you understand from the heading and the subheading that what this article could be about? Thoda bahut changes ho sakta hai. Now let's start with the first paragraph. Again, assuming we are knowing nothing about it. ठीक है? The underlying gender bias in unpaid care work is a critical factor contributing to gender inequality. Now here this term in itself giving you gender inequality. इसीलिए मैंने यहाँ पे लिखा gender inequality. तो आपको पता है कि नाउ दिस आर्टिकल विल टॉक अबाउट सोशल इश्यूज, इट विल टॉक अबाउट वुमेन इश्यूज स्पेसिफिकली, एंड अमंग दैट जेंडर इनइक्वालिटी इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द टॉपिक्स. ठीक है, नाउ व्हाट इट इज शोइंग हियर इज द अंडरलाइन जेंडर बायस इन विच सेक्टर, इन द अनपेड केयर वर्क. वुमेन आर टेकिंग केयर ऑफ द चिल्ड्रेन एंड दे आर अनपेड फॉर दैट, देर इज नो पेमेंट डन फॉर दैट. Or this sounds also very weird sometimes because of the structure that we have in our society, that how can you, since a mother is taking care of the children, what's about the payment here? But then, okay, we will see as we, you know, proceed, we will get an insight about it. So let's forget about it. Since I have just read it, toh mere dimag mein hai, but abhi ke liye we are assuming ki hum toh isko pehli baar kar rahe hain. So what are the things that we understand from here? That there is some issue related to gender bias in the sector of unpaid care work. Theek hai? And this is a very important factor or a critical factor which is contributing to gender inequality. Abhi tak we will not write anything. Wo side wala aap 2 minute ke liye bhul jao. Just focus what I'm telling. This is said by, so this is like it's says the ILO latest report. Which organization is being talked about here? International Labour Organization. So from here you will start making your notes, because ye jo ek cheez hai ye aapko common sense se samajh aayegi. That would be repeated because that's the main theme of the entire article. But who is the body here or the organization here? And assuming that we are not knowing anything, so we will go to the static portion. We will write ILO, International Labour Organization, in our notes, and we will read more about this particular organization. So yahan se saath mein aapko iska static portion cover karna hai, theek hai? Aap apna web search kar sakte ho, kisi kitab se milta hai. तो ILO, ये लेबर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का काम क्या है, और इनके और डिटेल्स को आप पढ़ोगे, किस तरह के रिपोर्ट्स ये पब्लिश करते हैं, दीज आर द थिंग्स, वो बैकवर्ड में यू हैव टू मेक द नोट. ठीक है, ओके. सो देयर इज सम लेटेस्ट रिपोर्ट व्हिच इज रिलीज्ड बाय ILO व्हिच सेज द अबव थ्री लाइंस दैट वी हैव सीन. द ILO's 2017 ग्लोबल सैंपल सर्वे एस्टैब्लिश्ड दैट 70% ऑफ वुमेन वर ईगर टू बी इन द पेड एम्प्लॉयमेंट आउटसाइड देयर होम. Now what we are trying to do here is not reading the entire article at once and then making the notes. You can also do this, you can underline the important part, highlight it, and then make the notes alongside. But I am not doing it for the reason that that is a very easy approach and that can be done by anyone. That need not be taught. What needs to be taught is, by chance if you are doing the thing simultaneously, how do you then carry it out? Okay, so wo mera approach rahega. So this, now the first lines, we are done with that. This says that ILO की जो 2017 की ग्लोबल सैम्पल सर्वे थी, उसके अलावा इफ यू नीड टू राइट समथिंग अबाउट दिस रिपोर्ट जो रिलीज हुई है, सो यू कैन राइट दैट ओके सम रिपोर्ट इज सेइंग दैट देयर इज जेंडर इनइक्वालिटी एंड द मेजर कॉज फॉर दैट इज जेंडर बायस इन अनपेड केयर वर्क. दिस इज वॉट आई हैड रिटन इन माई ओन लैंग्वेज. ओके, forget about what the other things are written. This is just what I have written, which was given here in the first paragraph. Now, we do not know the name of the report yet. It is not being discussed in the article abhi tak to. Theek hai? So, we will include it jab wo aayega. अब ILO के 2017 में ILO ने ग्लोबल सैंपल सर्वे किया, ठीक है. 2017 का जो रिपोर्ट था उसने बोला, उस रिपोर्ट के अकॉर्डिंग 70% ऑफ वुमेन, ठीक है, देवर ईगर, ईगर मतलब वो इंटरेस्टेड थी काम करने में. किस चीज़ के लिए? कि वो घर से बाहर, आउटसाइड देयर होम, दे नीडेड टू बी एंगेज इन दी, और देवर ईगर टू बी एंगेज इन दी पेड एम्प्लॉयमेंट. सो 70% ऑफ वुमेन एज पर दी 2017 सर्वे were interested in paid employment outside home. But an ILO study last year, matlab 2018 mein, found that only about 45% of women had jobs. So 70% of women were eager in 2017 to have jobs outside home and getting paid for it. But the reality of 2018 was that only 45% of them had jobs. This underscores the gap between their desire and reality. Desire 70% ka tha, reality sirf 45% ke liye ho paayi. Now it says, the report. Now they are giving you the name of the report. A quantum leap for gender equality for a better future of work for all. This entire, you know, which I have highlighted here is the name of the report, which was launched earlier this month. So therefore, wherever you have written, you know, this report point earlier, now you can write here the name of the report. ठीक है, आप उसको ऐसे include करेंगे because you have not read the article at once. तो वो आपको समझना पड़ेगा. Okay. Since this was launched earlier this month, मतलब March 2019 में, and this report shows that unpaid care work posed the biggest impediment to women's employment. So जहाँ पे आपने उस report के बारे में थोड़ा सा लिखा था, here only you can mention about this biggest impediment to women employment also. If you want, you can write. Otherwise, this point is anyways giving you an idea what they are trying to say. Some 21.7% of women of working age. Now, पिछले उसमें मैंने बहुत time, बहुत energy लगा के इस point को explain किया था. वो video जो खत्म हो गया, मतलब चला गया. What I was saying is that, see, this is how you get to understand about, you know, reading paragraphs also. Jo reading comprehension aapka CSAT mein bhi use hota hai, usme ye technique bahut kaam aati hai, and this is a skill which you need to develop in case you are new to reading and, you know, reading stuff. Here they are telling some 21.7% of women of working age. They could have written 21.7% of women are engaged in full time, in caregiving without pay. But they have mentioned a special term, and if you do not pay attention, if you do not read the article on your own, if you depend on other people doing this work for you, you can never ever focus on this. Every single word of the article has to be read and then decided that ki ye important note mein aayega ya nahi. So if you miss out on this term somehow, considering you are a beginner, if you already know the concepts, you will understand ki what they are trying to say. What is this working age? Why simply not women are being talked about? Why women of a specific age are being talked about? What is this concept of working age population? Kis age group ke log is particular age mein consider kiye jaate hain? Maine apne starting mein padhaya hua hai. Agar in case aapne nahi padha hai aur new hai, so that, considering that, what I am saying is, अगर आप इस पॉइंट को इग्नोर कर दोगे तो आपके लिए प्रॉब्लम आएगी. सो ये आपको समझना पड़ेगा कि व्हेन यू आर रीडिंग, यू हैव टू फोकस ऑन एवरी की टर्म दैट दे आर यूजिंग इन द न्यूज़पेपर. दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन दैट फॉर यू, दे विल जस्ट मेंशन. तो आपको स्टैटिक में वर्क क्या करना है, दैट यू हैव टू फाइंड अबाउट वर्किंग एज पॉपुलेशन, उसके स्टैटिक वो क्या एज ग्रुप आता है, दैट यू विल हैव टू राइट. ओके, सो द रिपोर्ट सेज दैट 21.7% ऑफ वुमेन, दे आर इन ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर ग्रुप, are engaged full-time in caregiving without pay. And only 1.5% of men fall in this category. So what they are telling is, is report ka jo ye data hai, wo kya bol raha hai? Ki working age population mein, jo log full-time caregiving, theek hai, pure din bachche ki jo care, matlab full-time, unka aur koi kaam nahi, part-time, full-time jo kaam hota hai na, considering that. So full-time caregiving mein they are involved and they are not getting paid for that. Among those age group or that age group जो है working age group, उसमें women form about 21.7% and men are only 1.5%. So the difference between them is very much clear and you can see this inequality existing. The next paragraph says the impact of unpaid work on women manifests itself at many levels. So at different levels, we do understand that, you know, this phenomena of unpaid work, which is hampering the women, it is having a kind of impact. What are those kind of impacts? So we have given this heading, impact of unpaid work on women. The first they are talking about is motherhood penalty. As you can see here, motherhood penalty. So I have written the first point exactly what it is given, because that's a term, which means that mothers in the workforce, they experience additional disadvantages compared to women who are not the mothers. Because if there are women who are not the mothers, they still have the opportunity to manage their lives. ठीक है, वहाँ पे payment नहीं, payment की उतनी बात नहीं हो रही है. But if they are mothers and they are not able to, you know, work outside, they are not able to get payment for some other outside work, it is basically very difficult and they are somehow getting the additional disadvantage because they are mother. So just imagine, giving birth to a child is the most, you know, best thing that can happen. मतलब सबसे कुछ अच्छा, सबसे pure जो हो सकता है वो चीज़ है ये. And then there is something called as motherhood penalty, only for the reason that these working, you know, like these mothers, they want to work, but they cannot probably as compared to other women. And therefore, they are facing additional disadvantage just because they are mother. Matlab, this is so ironical, but this is the reality. Isme emotional nahi hona hai, practical socho, facts se socho. So this is the reality. So you can write the description about, you know, which they have given here. What is the meaning of this term motherhood penalty in the notes? I am not writing. Also, this is more acute for women who are having children of 0 to 5 age group. Because agar unke bachche chote hain, to unko zyada care ki zarurat hai. And therefore, the mothers probably, you know, they are not working during that time. And then they are focusing more on their children. If they have older children, somehow still the mother, they manage. To wahan pe unke case mein thoda risk kam hota hai. But for, you know, those mothers who have children in the age of 0 to 5 age group, are facing this difficulty a lot. So this is also one kind of impact. So therefore, the second point says more acute for mother with children of 0 to 5 age group. ठीक है, और older लिखने की जरूरत नहीं है, because that is understood. In addition, there is also the parenthood employment gap that unfairly privileges fathers. You know this very well. अगर आपको थोड़ा भी दीन दुनिया के बारे में पता है, you understand कि कहीं ना कहीं इस चीज़ में, यू नो, फादर्स दे आर गेटिंग प्रिविलेज्ड एंड एज सच उनको जॉब ना छोड़ना है, केयर गिविंग के साथ स्टिल दे आर गेटिंग पेड. मदर्स के साथ वो चीज़ नहीं होती. सो देयर इज़ अनदर इम्पैक्ट विच इज़ पेरेंटहुड एम्प्लॉयमेंट गैप, वेयर देयर इज डिस्कशन अबाउट फादर्स प्रिविलेज. द आई एल ओ रिपोर्ट्स एंड इंक्रीज इन बोथ दीज ग्रुप्स इन सेवरल कंट्रीज दैट वर सर्वेड. More starkly, there is a wage penalty associated with motherhood. So, जब इन्होंने इतना survey किया in different countries, they found that motherhood के साथ they find something called as wage penalty. आपको इस पर research अलग से करना होगा, I cannot go into the details. And fatherhood के साथ they found wage premium. तो एक तो मतलब mother, you know, a woman is being a mother, already she is suffering a lot. अगर आप थोड़ा emotional side अटा करके physical side को देख रहे हैं, the pain and everything and, you know, the effort, the energy, सब कुछ, मतलब the important वो जो time, अगर working women है, they are also somehow making things feasible for them, still they have to face something like wage penalty. And fatherhood के साथ अगर कुछ associate हो रहा है based on ILO survey, it is wage premium. So आप इसके बारे में और detail पढ़ सकते हैं if you need to do that. So इसका static I am writing, if you are interested, go ahead and read more about it. We are just seeing the impact, so the short pointers. This translates into a leadership penalty. Only about 25% of women, though you can also write that, okay, only 25% of women with young children, okay, who are having young children, and they are just only 25% of them are able to occupy or are set to occupy managerial positions, because wo leadership mein bhi penalty aati hai, because wo wage mein penalty hoti hai. And this contrasts with some 75% among fathers in the comparable situation. So, agar 70, matlab, wo fathers, theek hai, jinke bacche chote hain, young children hain, unme se about 75% of them are having the managerial position. But young children mein, if you talk about the mothers, only 25% of women are, you know, with young children, they are having the managerial positions. So, yahan pe ek aur impact kya aa raha hai? ये लीडरशिप पेनल्टी. सो दिस पॉइंट यू कैन राइट हियर, लीडरशिप पेनल्टी. अनदर पॉइंट इज इन द नेक्स्ट पैराग्राफ, A skewed distribution of unpaid work yields unequal dividends from educational attainments. ठीक है, अब यहाँ पे क्या हो रहा है कि एक हमें अनइक्वल डिविडेंड दिख रहा है एजुकेशनल अटेनमेंट से भी. कैसे? जेंडर इनरोलमेंट गैप्स वर सेड टू हैव क्लोज्ड बाय 2017. ठीक है, सेकेंडरी और टर्शियरी एजुकेशन में ये बात हुई कि 2017 तक जो जेंडर इनरोलमेंट गैप्स है, जो बच्चे इनरोल कर रहे हैं वो किस जेंडर को बिलोंग करते हैं. ठीक है, जैसे सेक्स रेशियो काइंड ऑफ थिंग होता है ना, मतलब मेल फीमेल के हिसाब से हम काउंट करके देखेंगे, तो वो जो जेंडर इनरोलमेंट में जो गैप था मेल चाइल्ड और फीमेल चाइल्ड के बीच में, दैट वॉज सेट टू हैव क्लोज्ड बाई 2017 सेकेंडरी और टर्शियरी एजुकेशन में. लेकिन स्टिल women make up over 69% of youth who are not in employment, education or training. तो अगर वो gender enrollment gap कम हो रहा है या almost खत्म पर है, तो why are these women having this much percentage, 69% of women who are young and still not have, are not employed or not in education or not in training? Why? These numbers should explain that why the bulk of women drift into unpaid care activities. इस नंबर को बताना पड़ेगा क्यों इतनी सारी women जो कि employment के लायक थी, education, training के लायक थी, क्योंकि वो gender enrollment ratio, जो gaps है वो वैसा नहीं है. So why are they still in the majority in the unpaid job? ठीक है, so despite of minimal gender enrollment gaps in 2017, and नहीं होगा, over 69% of young, over 69% of young women are not in, यहीं पे वो गड़बड़ हो गया था कुछ टेक का, एंड यू नो आई हैड टू स्टॉप. सो दे आर नॉट इन एम्प्लॉयमेंट, एजुकेशन और ट्रेनिंग. In most of the developing world, even when they are engaged in paid work, so either the women are drifted towards unpaid care activities, or even if they are in paid work, it is predominantly in the unorganized sector. So we can write it as either in unpaid care activities or paid work in unorganized sector. Among adults with a university degree, now if you are moving ahead about talking about university degree, adults, 41.5% of women are either unemployed or outside the labor force, compared to 17.2% among men. So again, you know, eighth number, agar hum point dekhte hain, agar hum यूनिवर्सिटी डिग्री वाले एडल्ट्स की बात करें, यूनिवर्सिटी डिग्री एडल्ट्स की बात करें, तो विमेन अगर हम बात, और उसमें भी हम बात करें जो अनएम्प्लॉयड या आउटसाइड लेबर फोर्स हैं, उनके पास यूनिवर्सिटी की डिग्री भी है, फिर भी दे आर अनएम्प्लॉयड और आउटसाइड लेबर फोर्स. इसमें विमेन 41.5% और मेन 17.2% हैं. तो दैट डिफरेंस अगेन इज एग्जिस्टिंग हियर, बट दोज हु मैनेज टू ब्रेक थ्रू बैरियर्स आर बेटर क्वालिफाइड देन मेन एंड राइज टू द टॉप इवन फास्टर, एंड दैट इज वेरी मच क्लियर इन द सोसाइटी. जिन औरतों के साथ ऐसा होता है या वो कर पाती है, उनमें हिम्मत होता है, दोज हु आर रेडी टू ब्रेक द बैरियर्स, दे आर इवन बेटर क्वालिफाइड देन मेन. देर आर मेनी मैन हु माइट बी जस्ट ग्रेजुएट्स ऑफ द, विथ नो ऑफेंस, जो डेटा है वही बता रही हूँ, graduates or post-graduates, women are going for the higher studies, but very limited number, and they rise to the top even faster than men. Across the world, over 44% of women managers hold an advanced degree as compared to 38.3% among male counterparts. A rebalancing of current roles is critical to expand the arena of paid work for women and reduce the long working hours for men. So what, this is the concluding part of the article, and the author is trying to say that if you know the current role which is given or kind of is existing in the society for men and women, if a rebalancing is done here, ki women ko itna biased hoke unpaid karne ki zarurat nahi hai aur men ko itna favor agar ho raha hai to wo karne ki zarurat nahi hai, if that happens, if that rebalancing happens, that is very critical if we really need to expand the arena of paid work for women. Ki aaj women, you know, very few percentages of women are in the paid arena, so paid work arena, so that if needs to be expanded, so we have to balance or rebalance the current roles assigned to men and women. And it will, you know, and there is also a need to reduce the long working hours for men. That may also be the answer to promoting women's participation in the workforce. So if all these things will happen, it will also promote women's participation in the workforce. So if it quickly try to summarize, agar hum ek concluding point ki tarah thoda sa likhne ki koshish kare. If current roles are rebalanced, it will have certain impact. What kind of impact? It will lead to expansion of paid work arena for women. नाउ अगर ज़्यादा वीमेन भी काम करेंगी तो मेन्स को जितना ज़्यादा मेन को जितना ज़्यादा काम करना पड़ता है ना तो लॉन्ग वर्किंग आवर्स दैट वुड ऑल्सो बी रिड्यूस रिडक्शन ऑफ लॉन्ग वर्किंग आवर्स फॉर मेन यू कैन जस्ट राइट मोर वीमेन्स पार्टिसिपेशन इन द वर्कफोर्स. So guys, I hope, you know, it helped. See, it took me really long time to complete just a small article and I chose a very small article for the reason so that I save time online. But mujhe itna time sirf isliye laga because I had to read line by line in front of you and explain that how do we go ahead with that. So, aap agar jab apne se practice karenge, once you start practicing it yourself, it will not take much time. And once you become, you know, with practice, you will become a kind of pro in that and it will really take lesser time. थोड़ा लंबा वाला जो आर्टिकल होता है बड़ा वाला इट टेक्स रियली थोड़ा सा ज़्यादा टाइम इन छोटे आर्टिकल से या ओपिनियन से बट इट्स ओके इट इज़ वर्थ गिविंग. आप देख रहे हैं यहाँ से आपको कितना इन्फॉर्मेशन मिला एंड देर आर अ फ्यू आर्टिकल समटाइम्स विच आर जस्ट रिलेटेड टू द पॉलिटिकल स्टफ्स और कुछ ऐसी बातें होती है विच आर नॉट रेलिवेंट फॉर द एग्जामिनेशन सो दैट एनी वेज कैन बी स्किप्ड. ठीक है वो फिल्टर करना आपको सिलेबस समझ कर आएगा. वंस यू आर थरो विद दैट यू विल बी इजिली अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट. सो आई थिंक यू नो दिस वॉज हेल्पफुल. इफ यू रियली फाउंड इट हेल्पफुल अगर आपको लगा कि मेरी ये जो डबल मेहनत एक तो आज हो गई तो अगर वो आपके लिए थोड़ा भी बेनिफिशियल लगा इस प्लीज डू लाइक कमेंट शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब टू द चैनल. आई विल बी सीइंग यू इन अनदर वीडियो. आई सी कि व्हाट ऑल स्टफ्स रिलेटेड टू करंट अफेयर्स कैन बी कवर्ड बाय मी नॉट जस्ट गिविंग यू द करंट अफेयर्स कुंजीज और शॉर्टकट्स बट ऑल्सो टू टेल यू हेल्प यू इन अंडरस्टैंडिंग हाउ टू गो अहेड विद दीज करंट अफेयर्स थिंग्स इफ यू आर अ बिगिनर. ठीक है और इवन इफ यू आर अ ओल्ड प्लेयर इफ यू माइट बी बेनिफिटेड बाय इट. सो गाइस सी यू इन द अनदर वीडियो. स्टार्टिंग भी साथ बाई साथ चल ही रहा है सो आई विल बी मेकिंग वीडियोस सून देयर ऑल्सो. Take care till then. Bye-bye. Good evening yet again. See ya.